Hello everyone, in this tutorial I am going to use generic classes which provide us to define methods or class or interfaces without an specified type, and the type can be decided inside when we invoke the program. For this, I am going to start a console application program, and we are going to make we want enter array of digits, and then we are going to make array of digits, strings or double, and we are going to print it out, and we are going to add an element or delete an element. For this I need a class, and I call it to public class my container, and we are going to have a T as type, which is a generic argument or parameter, and we are going to have a list, private list. The same parameter T, unknown data type, call it data, and it is new list T, and then we are going to have a property public int size. And we have a get return data count, data dot count, and we have a constructor public my container, and we are going to use another constructor with I enumerable elements. Then we are going to check if elements not equals to null, and elements any dot any. Data dot add range element, add range adds an entire collection of elements. And after that, after that, we are going to define methods, public print, public void print, and we are going to use console. We are going to use another method, public void summation, and in that we are going to have a decimal d. Sum has the type of a generic class and default the default t, and var type is type of t. Okay, and then we are going to have a condition: if type equals to type of int. Now we are going to have our choose of variable. We are going to have a type of long, then we are going to use a sum plus equals to dynamic dot dot select x. You are going to use a lambda expression. Long convert change type x and type of what we are doing, we are going to add the sum of the quarter of variables. Else here, else if, is double or it is decimal. Then we have copy, paste, and we have dynamic, and here is double, and the type of double here else going to console dot right line. I am thinking if I can use it here or in the main program. I am waiting on this. Okay. Here we are going to have a console dot write line. We are going to use that the sum of quarters is sum. Going to have a method public void add, element, and its type is T, which is the generic variable, and we are going to use data dot add element. Another method is public bool delete int index, and we are going to use data dot remove at index, and we are going to use return true, and after that we have a public decimal multiply T1, T2. We are going to use the local variable decimal D1, D2, and then we are going to return decimal dot try parse T1.toString out to D1, and if it is so, this is D1, otherwise 0M multiplied by T2 and D2 and D2. Now we are going to define public bool try parse. Return decimal dot try parse element dot to string out value. We are going to our main method. And we define on local variable define d int I. String is 0 equals to y, and then we are going to use a while loop while s0 equals to y. Then console dot write line, please enter an array of digits, and then variable s equals to console dot read line dot split with the spaces. And then we are going to use if s dot all x double try parse of x out to d. Container equals to new my container double, and it is s select. This lambda method, this replaces of for each or something like that, because we cannot have a if and for or for each at the same. That is because we use the lambda expression, and here I use container dot print. We call the print a method, and then container dot summation, we call it also, and we are going to use ask please enter an integer to add into array. Going to use container dot add double parse what we read from the screen, we are going to put in our list or our array, and then we are going to print the array, and then we are going to an index of the element to be removed from the array, and then we are going to call the method, and this is int parse, and after that we are going to print the array again, and if that condition is not good, we are going to use else if s dot all x int try parse of x out I, and it is int. Going to call all those if all those variables can be converted to double, or if it all the variable can be converted to parse. Int and here is int parse, else we have characters, it is impossible to quarter chars. Going anyway dot item. Should see everything is okay or not. What is doing an aggregate function returns a single value, and the aggregation function is required to perform mathematical operations. Add range at an entire collection of elements. That is because it is correct, but I have an error. Why doesn't know about C? I should see if I have link here. Has S? Yes, it has it. It has. Going to continue with these things that it doesn't work. These things I don't need them, and we are going to add a digit to add a character to add mistake and it was a comma instead of dot. So I have completed and everything is okay. Now we are going to use our copy. Do you want to continue? Yes or no? And it was S0 equals to console dot read line, and I must check that it was S0. Yes, S0. Okay. Now we are going to run. for example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and the sum is 55. I am going to add 9, and 9 is added, and I am going to use 0, 1, 2. I am going to move 3, and 3 is removed. Now I am going to make a 1.2, 3.4, 5.6, 7.8, 9, 9. And the variables is there, and the sum of the quarters is 186.2, and I am going to add 12.6, and it's up here. I am going to remove 0, 1, 2, 3. I am going to remove 4, and 9 is gone, and it worked. Now I am going to continue with A, B, C, D. And it is impossible to quarter characters, and I am going to add G, and it has appeared G, and I am going to remove the first, and it is A is gone. Okay, it was all in this tutorial. Thanks for watching, and see you on next tutorial.